Good evening, this is Rashad Mitchell, coming to you live from my YouTube channel as I continue on my part series, The Understanding Black Music History, part 253 for December 10th. Let's get into it. December 10th, the number one R&B song in 1983 was Time Will Reveal by The Barge. December 10th, 1949, 21-year-old Antoine Fats Domino recorded his first million seller, The Fat Man. The song, originally called Junkers Blues, was written by Domino and songwriter Dave Bartholomew. Fats went on to sell more than 65 million records in a six-decade career. December 10th, 1966, Jackie Wilson's Whispers Getting Louder became the star's crossover to soul music as a recent number 11 pop number 5 R&B. Now, the song was written by Secretary of Carl Davis, Wilson's producer. She would later go on to have some hits of her own as Barbara Acklin, including Love Makes a Woman in 1967. December 10th, during a flight to a performance in Madison, Wisconsin, Otis Redding's new plane crashed, killing the soul singer and all but one member of the band, the Barclays, Who's Who of Southern Soul singers, including Sam Moore of Sam and Dave, Percy Sledge, Joe Simon, Joe Tex, Don Covey, and Solomon Burke served as pallbearers. 1983, December 10th, Rick James and Smokey Robinson's duet, Ebony Eyes, charted, reaching number 43 pop, number 22 R&B. The original release listed the artists as Rick James and Frank. December 10th, 1988, Natalie Cole won the Best Female Artist category at NAACP's 21st Image Awards. December 10th, 1995, Michael Jackson received word from his wife, Lisa Marie Presley Jackson, that their marriage of 18 months was over. As with their wedding, the public didn't find out for a month. Finally, on December 10th, 1997, Wyclef John and the Fugees performed at the Beacon Theater in New York at the Gift of Song concert in honor of, I think this is United Negro College Fund. I think that's what it is. UNICEF's 50th anniversary. I might be wrong, but that's what the performance was about. Gift of Song in honor of that UNICEF 50th anniversary. So that concludes the look at December 10th for Understanding Black Music History Part 253. Please like, subscribe to the channel. Do the video some magnitude tomorrow. Until then, talk to you soon.